Good morning, children. In the previous class, we have already learned about the numbers. In that topic, what we have studied, just once we reveal about it. Writing the numbers in ascending and descending order, and writing the place value and face value of a particular digit in the given number, and what is less than and what is greater than, that also we discussed about that, and about Roman numerals and Indo-Arabic numerals also we have studied. Now, using this knowledge, we are going to study about the second lesson. The second lesson is fundamental operations. The topic name is fundamental operations. What are the fundamental operations? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. These are called the fundamental operations. How many operations are there? There are four operations. Four fundamental operations are there in the arithmetic. What are they? Addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. Okay, children. So, now using the fundamental operations, let us practice some problems. In this topic, very in the beginning, one simple exercise is there. This is a review exercise. By keeping the heading ready study. Okay. First one is A. In the A section, answer the following is there. Answer the following. What we have to answer here? First question. See, there are some questions. Okay, in them, let us discuss about 1, 4, 6. 1. What is the first question? If 4562 plus 1324 is equal to 5886, what is 5886 minus 4562? That is the question mark. Okay. After the two numbers, sum of the two numbers is 5886 given. Now, from this point, he asked one question here. What is 5886 minus 4562? That means here, sum of the two numbers is 5886. Now, in the question, sum of the two numbers minus first number is there. Sum of the two numbers minus first number. If we subtract the first number from the sum of the two numbers, then what we get? We get the second number. That means 1324 we get. Why? Because sum of the two numbers is 5886. Here, from the sum means what here? Addition. From this result, he is subtracting the first number. If we subtract the first number, then we get the second number. If you want to get the second number, what you have to do? From the sum, you have to subtract the first number. So, that is the key point involved in this. Okay, children. So, here, what we have to write means that is equal to 1324. Just to check your answer, you do subtraction thereafter. 5886 minus 4562. 6 minus 2, 4. 8 minus 6, 2. 8 minus 5, 3. 5 minus 4, 1. 1324 is what? Okay, children. So, the main point we have to study here, if the sum of the two numbers is given, then to get the first number, we have to get the first number, we have to subtract the second number from that. If you want to get the second number from the sum, you have to subtract the first. So, first number is equal to their sum minus second number. Second number is equal to their sum minus first number. Okay, children. Now, let us go to the next question. Fourth question is here. What is 5025 plus 0 equal to? Question mark. Here, what is added? 0 is added. You know that 0 has no value. 0 has no value. That's why, if we add 0 to any number, we get back the same number. Okay, children. Here 0 is added to 5025, then what is the result? We get the same number, that is we get back the same number. Why? Because 0 has no value. 0 means nothing. That's why if we add 0 to this, again we get, what is the answer here? The result is 5025. Next. Now, what is 5000? Now, 6 one say, what is 5025 minus 5025? Equal to. In this problem, observe the same number is subtracted from the given number. Here, the given number and the number which is subtracted, both are same. Same number is subtracted from the given number 5025. So, then in this case, what we get? 0 we get. Why? Because from the given number, the same number is subtracted. Both are equal here. That's why, if after subtraction, we get 0. 5000. So, here answer, what is the result here? 0. In the margin, you can check this answer. 5025 minus 5025. That is equal to 0. 5 minus 5 is 0. 2 minus 2 is 0. Okay. 0, the total result is 0. Finally, we are getting 0. Why we are getting 0? Because the same number is subtracted from the given. That's why we are getting 0. Now, come to next one. B, Roman number B. Multiply the following multiplications. Okay, in the first chapter, already we studied about the multiplication. So, to check your knowledge, in this review exercise, he has given this ERP. Okay, that question is given to you. Multiply the following. What we have to multiply? See? A, fourth one. In the Roman B, some problems are there. Just for your understanding, I will teach fourth one, fifth one, and seventh. Now see fourth one. 156 into 4. 156 into 4. B. Fourth question. 156 into 4. Yeah. 156 is a 3-digit number. There are 3 digits. Units, tens, hundreds. 3 digits are there. 156 into 4. 4 is a single digit number. So we are going to learn a multiplying a 3-digit number with a single digit. Okay, 3-digit number is to be multiplied with a single digit. So you see here, 156, how to multiply, explain? 156 into 4. Now, you start the multiplication from right to left. What is the digit in the unit place? 6. Multiply 6 with 4 first. 6 into 4. 6 was 24. Now, write 4 here. 4 cancel and write here. Now, 2 is there, keep in mind. Next, second plus digit, 5 is there. 5 into 4. What is 5 into 4? 5 into 4, 20. For this 20, here 2 is there now. 4 is tried already, we wrote there, and 2 is there previous, so that 2 we have there.
20 plus 2.
How much?
22.
Now, two stripe of right here and another two is there. Keep in mind. Now, multiply the 100 plus digit with 4. 4 ones are 4. 4 plus here, how much is there? 2 is there. 4 plus 2, 6. So, 156 into 4 is equal to 624. Look at channel. 4, 6 are 24. 4 is actually here, 2 is there. 4, 5 are 20 plus 2, 22. And 2 is there. 4, 1 are 4 plus 2, 6. 624. Like this, we show the multiplication. Now, fifth one, say, 305 into 10. Here, the number 305, it is to be multiplied with 10. Which 10 we have to multiply. So, 305 into 10. So, according to your habit, how should you solve this? First you multiply with 0. 0 5 is 0. 0 0 is 0. 0 3 is 0. Next you multiply with 1. That means 1 5 5. 1 0 is 0. 1 3 is 0. Now add 0 5 0 3. 3 0 5 0. 3 0. 50. So 305 into 10 is equal to 3050. And here a simple logical point is that if a number is multiplied with 10, simply we give 0 as last. At the end of this number, we give 10. If the number is supposed multiplied with 100, then, in writing the answer, first you see, in 100 how many zeros are there? 2 zeros are there. So, simply, you keep 2 zeros at the last of this number. That means, the number is 305. Now, you have simply keep 2 zeros. This is like this. Okay, now you see, suppose, when the same number is multiplied with 1000, what will you do? Write the number 305. And how many zeros are there here? 3 zeros are there. So, simply keep 3 zeros. Okay. At the end of that number. Now, so, this is the process of, easy process of multiplying a number with 10, 100, 1000, etc. This is actual multiplication. This is without actual multiplication, just by observing the order in that we are multiplying very easily. Okay, children. So, now come to seventh one. Come to seventh one. What is this here? 48, seventh one, see. 48 into 27. This is the multiplication. Two digit number is multiplied with a two digit number. A two digit number is to be multiplied by a two digit number. So, here 48 is to be multiplied by 27. So, in this multiplication, we multiply the first number with the 27. How should we multiply? First, multiply with 7. First number is 7. With 7 you multiply. Multiply 48 with 7. That means, with unit digit, we multiply. After that, we multiply with the 10th digit. That means, 2. With 2 we multiply. So, first of all, now multiply 48 with 7. 8 into 7. 8 into 7 must be 8 7s are 56. So strike of 6. write in the jurisprudence. Now 5 is there, keep in mind. Now multiply 4 with 7. 4 sevens are 28. 4 sevens are 28. 28 plus here what is there? 5 is there. 28 plus 5. How much? 32. So write 33 here. Look at it. Now multiply the number 48 next to 52. So the multiplication is 2. 2 into 8, plates are 16. Plates are 16. Strike of 6. Write 6 in the tens place. Why? Because we are multiplying with the tens place digit. That's why write a 6 in the tens place. Okay, 2 8s are 16. 1 is there. Keep 1 in mind. Okay, now multiply 4 with 2 here. 4 into 2. 4 2s are 8. 8 plus here before what is there here? 1. 1 is in your mind already. So 8 plus 1, 9. Now add. 6. 6 plus 3, 9. 9 plus 3, 12. 1296. Like this, we show the multiplication. This is a habitual method because we have already studied in the first chapter. So, 1290. Like this, this is the process of multiplication. Okay, children.